Smartphone-based contact tracing is currently considered an essential tool towards easing lockdowns issued in response to the COVID-19 virus. But while the focus on developing smartphone-based contact tracing applications has been on privacy concerns, a question that has not received sufficient attention is, how reliable is smartphone-based electronic contact tracing for COVID-19? Philip H. Kent, assistant professor at TU Chemnitz University in Germany, explains how contact tracing apps work, why smartphones may not be the best devices to use, and what solution can produce a better result.
Smartphones are subjected to two major limitations related to contact tracing. Number one, the neighbor discovery cannot be done with an arbitrary granularity because there is a discovery latency, which implies that two devices have to stay within range for quite some time to see each other. For current tracing apps, this is around 4 to 5 minutes. So if you have multiple short contacts below 4 minutes, you risk losing them. The second limitation is related to distance estimation, and it can suffer from multipath propagation. If there's an object in between two smartphones, this object may attenuate the signal, in particular a human body. Then the signal arrived at the receiver is weaker. If the signal arrives weaker, then the distance that is estimated is larger than in reality, and then you consider the contact as not relevant.
Contact tracing applications on smartphones would benefit significantly if Apple and Google would provide access to the scan mode balance setting.
Contact tracing apps rely on an interface provided by the operating system developers. And this operating system imposes considerable strong limitations on how they can use it. These limitations could be overcome if the operating systems of the smartphones would grant full access to the radios, such that you can get down to latencies of a couple of seconds, which would be, I think, a good advantage.
The team came up with a promising solution to improve the reliability of contact tracing.
The alternative can be devices that are customly designed just for contact tracing. This could be small wearable devices that you maybe put in your pocket. They could provide very low latencies, provide a more robust distance estimation by using techniques such as time of flight, where you measure not just the attenuation, but how long a signal has traveled. There are fewer privacy issues on such devices because it's a dedicated low-content device, so you don't store any images or messages on them. They're just there for the purpose of tracing. And there is no risk of not handling them properly. So you don't have to install an app, you don't have to activate any Bluetooth.
Find out more in How Reliable is Smartphone-Based Electronic Contact Tracing for COVID-19, a contributed article in the January 2022 Communications of the ACM.